In the world of Pokemon, Ash Ketchum and Pikachu seem to be immortal, but they are far from that. The duo appears ageless, and time surely seems irrelevant. They have died, and it has happened more than once. If he has died more than once, how come he's alive now? How many times has he really died, and how? So many questions, and we got the answers. Ever since he was 10, Ash was passionate about becoming the world's greatest Pokemon master. Over the last 20 plus years, he has made some serious progress towards his goal. Our protagonist has died a few times. After all, he has been living in a world filled with dangerous Pokemon. To be exact, Ash has died about 7 times. Yes, you heard it right, 7 times. Ash's character has been killed mostly in Pokemon movies, and somehow he always comes back. Is Ash immortal? Let's first address this question. Nope, he's not immortal. He's just a regular human being, like us, who does seem to age differently though. But the lad can't go against the laws of nature. There are several situations during the anime and movies where Ash has died only to end up living in the subsequent events. This might have caused confusion about his immortality. Nope, Ash doesn't have superpowers. He has always been revived by some Pokemon's special abilities. Now, let's look at all the times Ash has died. 1. The Tower of Terror. In the 23rd episode of the Pokemon anime series, Season 1, Ash tries to catch disappearing Huntar and Gengar, but they eventually vanish through the floor. When Ash and Pikachu tumble to the ground, a chandelier falls on them. The Huntar and Gengar are seen pulling their souls from their bodies, only to be returned later. We are not sure if the duo really died. Number 2. Mewtwo Strikes Back. In the first Pokemon movie, Mewtwo Strikes Back, the jump between Mewtwo and Mew causes a heavy crash and destroys almost everything. The attack collides with Ash, turning him to stone. However, the tears of all the Pokemon, both original and cloned, resurrected him. Number 3. Lucario and the Mystery of Mew. In this movie, you will meet Blob, who is supposed to fight off and kill humans who approach the Tree of Beginning. Because Ash did just that, he gets killed by the Blob. He was eventually revived by Mew and his abilities. Number 4. I Choose You. In the Pokemon movie, I Choose You, Marshadow, a mythical Pokemon, commands several other Pokemon to strike and relentlessly assault Ash until Marshadow sends both his body and soul into the afterlife. Pikachu goes through a special portal to help Ash and magically revives him. Number 5. Manaphy and the Prince of the Sea. Here, Ash dies a natural death. While attempting to restore the sea crown in the castle, which is fast filling with water, he appears to drown. But thanks to the magical sea crown, Ash gains exceptional abilities and is able to save himself from drowning. So technically speaking, he doesn't really die here, he was just close to dying. Number 6. The Victini. In this movie, Ash ends up freezing to death. There is no way for a mortal to endure being frozen in space. Victini uses his heating abilities to revive Ash and bring him back to Earth in one piece. Number 7. Mewtwo Strikes Back. In the remake of this movie, Ash is turned into stone when he jumped between Mew and Mewtwo's blast to stop them from fighting. The tears from the original and clones bring him back to life. Apart from these events, Ash has been electrocuted by Pikachu's 100k volts, referring to the Pokemon XY series. Technically, he should have been dead, but nothing happens to him. He is able to withstand the electric shock. Well, this isn't new. Ash has been electrocuted several times, and it's probably a running gag by now. On one occasion, he even asked Pikachu to throw 100k volts at him. I hear you, it's a fictional anime and it's not real. But there must be a reason why such a huge amount of volts never killed him. And there is. Turns out, Ash's sneakers have kept him alive. A static shock is about 20k volts, but thanks to clothes and rubber shoes, you are able to build some resistance and mute the power of the voltage. Plus, Ash does not die because Pikachu has a glorified taser. He throws high voltage, but his current is low. Ash is a high-spirited, brave, yet gullible boy. He has always been willing to sacrifice himself for the good of his friends and his Pokemons. If he didn't revive every time he died, the Pokemon series would not have been the same.